Welcome to Module 22, and congratulations, you've made it to the final section. If you've got to this stage, you've got a pretty functional application, and now we're going to apply some final touches to this, and then publish it onto either a Linux server, or an Azure server, or both. So let's take a look at what's coming up in this particular module. First of all, we're going to look at applying some finishing touches to our application. What we have at the moment is a full page reload, or what certainly appears to be a full page reload. And it really isn't. All it is components that are re-rendering. But we've applied a big old loading indicator that covers our entire page of our application. And what we're going to swap that with is placeholder images that's going to give a much smoother, more responsive look to our application. We're also going to fix a feature with Safari that doesn't allow us to use the current date utility we're using to combine the date and time, and we need to make a correction to that. You may not have noticed, if you're not on a Mac, you for sure wouldn't have noticed, but if you have tried using Safari to create an activity, then you would have run into a problem. So we'll fix that. Then we're going to look at building a production version of our client application. Now, the tools that we're using to create our React application also provide us with comprehensive build tools that make this really easy to do. It's as simple as running a command to get a production version of our client application. And what we'll do with our production version of our client application is we'll actually serve it from our API server. So what we'll do is we'll enable the functionality on our API to be able to serve static files that we produce from our production version of our client application and serve them directly from the API server. Then we'll go ahead and build a production version of our API as well. And once again, the tooling that we're using with .NET CLI makes this incredibly easy for us to do. Once again, it's just a single command. What we'll also be doing in this section is adding support for additional database technologies. Now, we've been using SQLite up to this point, and SQLite is not a production-worthy database, not for an application that's going to reside on a web server. What we do need is what would be considered a proper production database server. And we're going to look at two additional ones here. We're going to look at MySQL and we're going to look at SQL Server. And what we'll see here is just how easy it is to switch between different database server technologies. If you've been concerned about using SQLite up to this point, then the time has come to take out SQLite. We're not going to take out SQLite completely because it's really useful for development. We can take our project and we can clone it onto another computer, and without having any database server installed, we can build and run our application simply by nature of the fact that SQLite just uses a file, and when we start our application, it's going to create that database file and we'll be able to run our application using that database in development. But like I say, we're going to add some additional providers so that we can make use of MySQL and SQL Server. Then we're going to look at publishing our application to Linux. And what we'll do to achieve this is we'll just create a cloud server that's going to host our Linux application, and we'll publish it to that so that we can see our application live on the internet. But what we'll find is that we've got a few security weaknesses in our application, so we're also going to look at tightening security of our application as well. And finally, we'll then publish our application to Azure. So let's just take a quick look at a before and after. And at the moment, as we click between different aspects of our application, then we get a full page reload when we do this, or what appears to be a full page reload. So let's now take a look at the after picture and what we're aiming to do by the end of this section and the end of this course. Now, this is a published version of our application. It's being hosted on a Linux server. And first thing you'll notice is that the connection is secure. We're using HTTPS to protect our site in this case. Now, I'm not expecting you to go out and purchase an HTTPS certificate, but I will show you the configuration to do so. But what we won't be doing is using a self-signed certificate on our Linux server. I'm just going to show you how to do it properly with a proper certificate so that we get a secure connection, and anybody who browses to this site from anywhere is going to be able to browse to this site securely. And what we can do, we can just log in as normal. So I'll just log in as bob@test.com. And once we're in, you'll notice straight away that we've changed the loading indicators basically. So as I click around the application, we can see that we are reloading our page, but we're only reloading the component. And instead of the full page loading indicator, now we're getting a much more responsive looking placeholder image. And this is the kind of technique that Netflix uses for their particular web application as well. All of our other functionality exists just as it did before. And we can go and browse to our photos, we can set our main photo, etc. But also, our application seems to have been given a speed boost, and that's because we've removed the delay that we added whilst in development. And our delay that we added in development was just an exaggeration of how our application's going to respond when it's published. What we're also going to do in this particular section is we're going to tighten the security. So I'm just going to copy the URL and paste it into the securityheaders.com site, which is going to scan our site and check for our security-related headers. And we're aiming for the Hall of Fame and not the Hall of Shame. And if I just paste in the link to this particular site and click on scan, then we get an A grade for the security rating for our site. And what we're going to be implementing is additional security policies that we send back to our browsers so that they only load up content that they actually trust. So this is what we're aiming for in this particular section. Final touches for our application, fix any bugs that exist, and then publish our application onto a Linux server, and we'll be doing the same for Azure as well, with using proper production database servers at the same time. So this is what's coming up. It's the final stretch, and let's begin.